Welcome everybody back to another video, Vista View Park. I'm doing things a little bit different this video. What I'm doing is I'm just kind of doing a live kind of viewing from the changes and stuff I've made. And the reason for this is because this park is getting a little bit out of control. And by opening it up and putting the guests in it, it is impossible to kind of record at the moment. Even on my system, it's still just, it's very laggy and very, very hard to do. I think I figured out a way to do this, so my video today is actually being recorded via the AMD Radeon Relive or Relive software, and it's kind of like NVIDIA's Shadow Play in a way. So AMD's kind of made their own for their new cards and everything. It's part of the new Crimson software, so definitely recommend that if you have an AMD card. It seems to be doing recording well. And there's not a performance hit. The frames per second still seem to stay the same. So it's a lot better than using OBS for this. Previously, when using OBS, it ended up getting just kind of... It would drop about 10 frames per second every time I tried to record on my computer. So, yeah, that just wasn't really working out. I rebuilt my old PC, my FX8350. And I tried using that as a secondary computer just to kind of stream over to that and then record using that stuff. But, I don't know, it's not working out well. I'm not getting the quality I want. And the AMD Radeon software seems to be doing the job from what I can find so far. So we will see how this turns out with this video. And with that little introduction done, let's get into the park and kind of show you what I've been working on this week since I lost a lot of my recordings and they weren't very good. So let's move on and let's kind of go up here. So one of the first things I did since the last time you saw the park is I've worked on the sign a little bit. You can kind of see I've added some like little trees and stuff to the actual sign over top of the entrance. And I think that turns out really well. I'm going to continue working on the actual front of the park a little bit more and kind of making it my own, because I know I used someone else's, you know, from the Steam Workshop as part of the actual entrance, and I'm going to try to make that my own just a little bit more, other than just kind of doing the pass. So now let's step into the park. There we go, and we got a beautiful, beautiful floral clock. Have I mentioned how much I love this clock? I'm actually going to go ahead and we're going to play the game. That's what we're going to do. Now let's go over here. And let's move into our new area over here. Do 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 do. Here we go. And Time Spiral. If you haven't seen the video yet, Time Spiral is done. I did post a video on there. It's gotten a ton of views. Thank you so much, guys, for watching that video and subscribing to my channel and everything that you've done in the past week since I posted that. It's been excellent. I really, really appreciate that. So, thank you so much yet again. I'm just going to turn the volume down here a little bit so it doesn't come through on the sound that I'm speaking. And, yeah, this is Time Spiral. And you can kind of see, let's talk about it a little bit. So, some people have mentioned that I should have filled the room up a little more and made like an attic or a bedroom or something. And I think they missed the point of what the coaster is. And that is kind of my fault, because I didn't really do much of a story for the actual coaster, even though I did have it in my mind. I've talked about it a little bit before in some of the forums. So this is Dr. Cogsworth's Clockworks Factory. And what we are doing with that is he has built a perpetual motion machine. And that is what you guys are testing. It's called Time Spiral. This, by the way, this sign came out really, really well. I still may do a little bit more work on the sign. Oh, we got trash in the park. Uh-oh. Yep. So, yeah, the sign came out really, really well. I'm very, very happy with the sign. I'm very happy with everything. This is probably the best thing I've ever done. And it's shown, because as of this very moment, I have almost 1,800 views on the Time Spiral video. If you haven't seen it, go check it out. Subscribe to me. Like it. Blah, blah, blah. Comment, etc. So, this is a giant cuckoo clock. It's not a house. It's not a bedroom, it's not a dining room or anything like that. It's a giant cuckoo clock. I thought that was kind of evident just from looking at the front of it, but I guess you just kind of seen it pass by kind of quick and you didn't really notice it. And yeah, we even got the little guys coming out and clanging that. I'm going to put a timing trigger on that so that actually when the coaster gets to a certain point, both of those guys come out and ring their bells. And I'm going to put another timing mechanism so you hear a bell sound at the top, if that's possible. I haven't tried it yet, but I think it is. So that when a coaster goes over the lift hill and makes the drop, the bells will ring. I think that'd be really cool too. We're also going to work a little bit more on the inside of our queue line in here, which I did kind of work on a little bit. As you can see, I'm missing a few spots though, so I gotta work on that. Many guests are hungry even though they have food, so yeah. This coaster, you can see it's getting a ton of, just like a ton of viewers and riders and stuff like that, so yeah. So we're gonna work on this. Some people with the little Robin Hood hats. I thought that fit this thing well. We're gonna work on the queue line. It kind of winds through here. I really want to put a priority pass in there, but I don't really know how to do it. So if I can figure out how to do that, I will definitely do that. But I really don't know how to do it. It would be great if I could separate it and maybe put like a different one so that they can come in from a different way to kind of get in here. But I don't know. So one thing I did was I actually made sure that there was enough clearance for the headroom here for the people to go through. That was something I had to work on. Got that taken care of. And then you come up in here. And then you can kind of see the people kind of coming through here. I also recolored the trains a little bit as well. And something else which you didn't see in the video, but I made it like a little view over kind of thing up in here. Where, oop, that's the wrong button. You can kind of see the coaster come up through here. So it's got a little railing and everything there. I thought that was kind of neat as well. And I don't know what I just did, but let's get back up in here. I am recording this live and talking live as I'm doing it. There's no editing in this video whatsoever. This is just going to record this and throw this up on YouTube here shortly. So, because I know you guys are waiting for another episode, and I've been really busy this week and I have not had a chance to do it. But yeah. This is the inside of the station. A little more work I got to do in here with some roofing and maybe fixing a little bit, a few more things in there. That will come, I think, towards the end of the park, just to kind of finish everything off. In the time spiral video, you notice I timed that perfectly so that a coaster came right over this track right as this one was getting ready to leave. And I'm going to be honest with you, I'm glad you guys liked that because I actually did not time that. That just kind of happened. It was just completely coincidental that that happened, and I didn't actually time that. Now we go off to the exit line. We're going to work on this exit line a little bit too. That will come later as well. Come down through here. And we're going to come out of this, and there we go. Now I kind of added some stuff over in there. I thought this area was kind of cool, and I worked with it a little bit. But we did some floral, some terraforming, some other things in there. This is actually Dr. Cogsworth here. I don't know why he's holding two swans, but yeah, Dr. Cogsworth and his fantastic clockworks. And that is the theme of this. Now, let's move over here. This is a really cool workshop gazebo kind of area that you can find on the workshop. And I'm sorry, I forgot the name of the person who did it, even though he was actually in my Twitch stream the other day. I did forget his name. But yeah, definitely check it out. Just search for gazebo on Workshop. You will find it. There's not many gazebos. I'm losing money. I constantly lose money. I also constantly have my shopkeepers quitting on me, like all the time. I cannot keep shopkeepers. Now, let's move over here. Tons of trash in the park. It's because all my my janitors all quit, and I just now had to hire them back, so yeah. This is Delighty Designers, her little castle fairy tale things on both sides of this, and Ryan's Midway Pavilion right here, which I changed it up a little bit. I changed kind of the corner. This is what it looked like. We're going to go over in here. I haven't worked back in here yet, so pay no attention. He had these brick things on here, which are fine, but I didn't really care for them too much. It didn't really fit my theme. So I came over here, I did some rock work around the edges, I did some flowers, I put these in here, and I changed the way that the pavilion actually looks. I also took out the roof of it, because he had a whole layer of a roof under there that was very flat. This whole spiral thing looks really cool, so we're going to keep this. And I did that so I could fit this tilt-a-whirl in there, which came out really, really well. But again, props to Ryan, man. This thing is amazing. Absolutely amazing work on this. You did such an excellent job, and it fit my area perfectly, too. I struggled with trying to find a flat ride, because I knew I wanted a flat ride over here, and I really struggled to find a flat ride that I could put here and still kind of make it an open, airy kind of area where you could see the entrance for Times Row and everything. And everything I tried was just, it was too big and everything. And the Tilt-A-Whirl was going to work, but and then I thought about using a carousel, but yeah, again. So props to Ryan for making this. You helped my park fantastically by doing this, and I mean, I would not have thought of this. This is just beautiful work. I don't even know how many hours that took you, but yeah. And again, Lady Designer's Fairy Tale area over here on this set as well. I don't know what I'm going to do with the spaces. I took the shops out, and we're going to change those. I did do over here, I put some bathrooms in, and that kind of fits this area a little bit. I haven't done anything on the other side over there or the queue line or anything, but we'll come back to that. That looks great. We're going to do some more trees, some more flowers, some more terraforming and things over in there. I did put some trees up behind there to kind of give it more of a look. Look at all this trash. Where are my janitors? Seriously. One person suggested they really wanted to see more of the red building over there. Again, that is just a steampunk kind of building that I found in a workshop, and it just really fit well into that area, so that went over there. Here we have our fest house, our October fest house. I don't really know what we're going to call it, but I got a lot of inspiration from looking up Bavarian architecture, and I found some buildings. Some of them are actually at Busch Gardens and some other places, but still, some Swiss, Bavarian, German architecture came up, and I found this right here, and it was a perfect thing for our gigantic Ferris wheel, which you can see from the outside of the park. And I did a lot of work to try to get that actually visible so you can see it as you're coming into the park, and it's kind of a landmark kind of thing. And what is it Silver Rick calls them? A weenie. So yeah, that is kind of a weenie right here. And this actually marks the entrance into another area, which we are going to work on at a much later time. Back in there is going to be our hyper coaster. We'll talk about that more later. So some more buildings that I got off the workshop. I didn't do these myself. I apologize. These are all from the workshop, and I just kind of modded them. So this is two different buildings, and I combined them into one building, which turns out really, really well. I love this purple color, too. It really stands out. We got a whole pond over here on this side. All right, and let's move on. I haven't done much here. We're going to do some rock work around these buildings. We're going to give this more of an alpine kind of layered buildings kind of look as you go up the hill. And so we'll put some rocks around this area. We're going to do some work with these stairs and this little patio area. I'll show you where the patio comes out in a minute. And this was really cool. And I didn't have to modify this too much, but I slightly did, but not too much. And we built a little restaurant up on a hillside here. Excuse me, I am yawning. Wow. I hate when I record live and I can't cut that stuff out. Alright, and this goes up into our dive coaster. And we're not going to go up in that area yet because there's not much to be seen up in there. We'll move it a little far up in here. I don't even have trash cans up in here. Yeah, there's a couple, I think. We haven't done the station for the dive coaster yet. That will be coming very, very soon. I did want to show this off. I wanted to kind of have this come down on both sides, but the way the pathing was going to work, I just could not get it to work. I literally tweaked on that for like an hour and finally gave up. And then we've got a couple little layered areas up in here, which are going to be some little like patio areas, I guess. And then we'll do a station for the Ferris wheel. Yeah. And of course, you know, you can kind of come up on this side, or you can take these stairs over here, which come up from over here. Oh, somebody threw up there. I think I may need to put a bathroom or something up in here. We'll do that. All right, and we come back down here. Let's go back over into Main Street. Now, as I've said before, you guys who have been watching the videos, all of this area right here, all of these buildings on this left side of the street, or right side, depending on which way you're looking, are all prefab things coming from the Steam Workshop. and that's where all of this comes from. We've got some stuff from Dr. Pompadumpadumpadless. I don't know his name. Dr. Pompadou? Yeah. There's some other stuff in here from somebody else as well. And most of all of these are kind of really cool alpine buildings. There was no point in me making all my buildings when there was perfectly good buildings to be used in there. I am going to alter them. I'm going to put the shops on the inside of the buildings because I don't like them being on the outside of the buildings like that. This doesn't fit. Let's move over to the other side of the park. We have our balloon ride here. Alpenkirch has just broken down. Good. Hopefully they'll fix that before we get over to it. We got our Venetian carousel, which it fits great there. I really wish we had a single layer carousel though that I could put somewhere else in the park. I mean, this one's nice. It looks beautiful. And I suppose it works, but it's just really hard to theme around. I'd much rather have like a gazebo or something there, which maybe I might build a gazebo around that. We'll see. We have our flying carousel over here. I don't even know what those are called. I'm at a loss. I know the name. I just can't think of what they're called. Giant swings, but yeah. I did work on the colors some there, and I don't know if I'm extremely happy with the colors, but it does look good. It turns out really well. Did some flower work in there, some stuff in there as well. And we're gonna move over here to this area. And for some odd reason, oh, I know why. Yeah. As I said, on the other side of the park, I'm gonna put the things on the inside of the buildings, and that's because of this building here. As you can see, I plan on working on this a little bit more, but see, we have our shop on the inside and the pass and stuff. Originally, I had two shops in here, so the paths are kind of a little different and weird, but nobody comes in here. I don't know why. This sign is moved. It was in the window. I moved this building. That's also why those crates or the barrels, the flower barrels there are kind of moved as well. So that's my bad. I did that. We have our bathrooms right here next to this. With a little entrance. If you go through the bathrooms, you come out to the other side. We'll go over there in just a moment. This building, I just finished up this weekend. Sort of finished up anyway. It's not completely done, but done enough. And we're going to put a shop in there. So, and then this building, which still needs a lot more work. It's kind of plain looking so far. This is actually the front facade of our bumper cars, which you can see in here. And again, gonna do a lot more work with this because this is not perfect, but the whole building hides the bumper cars. Even though the bumper cars are beautiful, they don't fit an alpine theme, so I decided to put them in an enclosed area and do that. Now let's come over here. We have our dive coaster as it comes down the street there. This is beautiful. This was the first thing I built in the park. This right here. The very first thing I ever built was this right here. And the rest of the park kind of formed around that. I've talked about that before, though, so I'm not going to waste time on that. We're already like 18 minutes into this video. We got a couple more prefab buildings over here on the side. These may change later on. I have some thoughts about a building, and I don't know what I'm going to do with it yet. I may just build it and just put it in a workshop, and I may build it and put it in this actual area right here. I don't know yet. We have a beautiful little waterfall, also from the Steam Workshop. A lot of this stuff did come from the Steam Workshop because I'm lazy. And again, why build something that's already been built? That works perfectly. Alpenkirch. Alpenkirch is based off of Banshee and a little bit off of Alpengeist. Again, I've talked about this before if you've watched my video, so we won't go into too much detail. I did do a little bit of work on some water and some other stuff in there, so that is going to be kind of cool. I fixed this up, so we're going to actually make some rocks and stuff and kind of make it layered. And let's get over here. And as you come into this area, here we go. This is our teacups ride. Going to work on some more on this. This will look much better the next time you guys see it. And I'm going to do some work on the outer facades of the back buildings here. And back over there. Now, as I said, this actually leads over to Main Street. I wanted to do something like this on the other side of the street, but it just wasn't going to work. And I, with the coaster on the other side of the park there, just there was no way to do it. So, only one entrance on this side of the street that goes over here. I put three different paths into this area over here to kind of make this like a pavilion type area. And we're going to go over in that way. But one thing I thought as I was working on this that kind of turned out really cool, and we're going to get an aerial view of this, is if you look at how this is done right here, these two trees area right here, that's really cool. I really like that. We're going to work with that some more. We're going to make that into like a little flower bed area. Then we have the magic twirl over here, which is going to have its own little entrance. And I think I'm going to call this Entwined. I saw a really cool, there's a coaster or something, or a show at Busch Gardens, maybe, I don't know. But it's got this, it's called Entwined, and it's got this really cool entrance to it. And I kind of like that, so I'm using the inspiration of that to make this. Oh, look at this, we have a tree that's just not even in the ground. I'll have to fix that. The queue path winds around through this little forested area, and actually over here where you will then get on the ride. But you can also see the ride from the outside as well. And this goes back to the front of the park down in there. We'll put some more trees. We may do something with this hillside here. Maybe a ride. Maybe a coaster. Maybe a mine coaster. Maybe. Maybe a log flume. Perhaps. We'll do something. Maybe even a wooden coaster. I don't know. I think the wooden coaster is going to be back in here, though. Now, let's go over here where Alpencurse is. Pay no attention to these pathworks because some of this is going to change. When I actually start doing the station, all of this is going to change right here. You can see I've put some water down in there, and I love how I fix this so that the coaster comes out and it goes underneath. Now, this is going to look like a cable car, like a ski lift kind of station, when it actually comes out. So we'll come out, wind down, go up, and then kind of at an angle up in there. And I'm going to redo all of the supports up through there as well, so that it does actually look like a ski lift. And I'm going to put our entrance area back in here. So the paths are actually going to kind of come down and will be over here, the entrance area and stuff. We'll kind of go over here and then wind maybe... maybe come up under this. I don't know yet. We'll do something with that. Again, we're still kind of far. One thing Frontier has done beautifully was the backgrounds and stuff in this, and it looks really, really cool. Now, there's not much over in here. Even my park guests don't even really wander over into this part, but this will be the next area that we develop after we get done with the other section behind Main Street there, where the Magic Twirl and all that is. We're going to come back in here, and we're going to develop this area out a little bit into like a ski area, like a ski resort kind of, ski mountain kind of thing. That is going to be the theme of this side. And you got some beautiful shots of Alpencurse here too. I put the pass particularly right around this so that you could see the coaster and how it flies through there and everything. And yeah. This right here, I put this, here, I'll show you. I did this specifically. I curved this path right around this because I knew I wanted to put a flat ride there, and I just had to figure out which flat ride. Eventually, I started to go with a Screaminator, and it did not look very good from the front of the park. So this does, however, so that's what we did. You can see I kind of brought this out and kind of curved this around. Gonna go back down in here. This is not the final plan for the queue lines or anything like that. This will actually be very, very different once it's actually done. Now, what I'm going to do over here on this side of the park will be our, not the log flume, the river rapids. I've decided, yes, I am going to put the river rapids on this side of the park because I think it fits best over here. And we're going to have it on this side, but it's actually going to come down and underneath of this path here. Okay, for some odd reason, the video card just bugged out, so I had to reboot the computer, but here we are back. And, alright, so what I was saying was I was going to put the River Rapids ride, and it's going to start over on this side of the park, and it's going to come down here and kind of run underneath of Alpencurse a little bit and kind of have some interaction with that, I think. That is something I kind of want to get into. We'll keep on going up the path here, and we are just about done. I could probably get this to run a little faster down through here, but I've got my settings turned down, so. This is a really cool little cavern that I've kind of put up here, and I will show you why. Because I really like the cave, kind of going through a cave. I'm going to have a waterfall come down from up in here. It's going to go underneath of the path, and it's going to come out into this water area over here. And then we're going to have, there is avalanche coming up down through here. As you can see, I kind of cut out kind of an area back in there, and it's going to look like it is going back in there and coming out down where the drop of Alpencurse is. So we're going to do a waterfall on the other side of the mountain over there as well. And we're going to come back over here. There you can see our Chief Beef over there. And this is the coaster for Avalanche, which I really haven't shown too much of, I don't think. And this is the end of our area. Yeah. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this kind of walk through the park. It's a little different than what I normally do because I mostly do time lapses showing off my construction and stuff. If you guys prefer the time lapses, let me know. If you prefer this way, kind of letting me do my work and then coming into the park and showing you all the changes and stuff I've done, let me know that as well. But basically, which do you prefer? Make your comments down below in the comments section. If you like this video, click that like button. If you don't like it, click the dislike button. You know, it's all the same to me. If you are going to hit dislike, though, at least tell me why. You know, don't just hit the dislike button and just move on. Just tell me why. I'm not going to yell at you, you know. And even if I do, it's not like you're going to hear me yelling at you. It's a video. So, you know, be nice, make your comments known, and let me know why you are not a fan of this video if you do hit that dislike button. If you do like it, I would also love to hear your remarks about that as well. That would be great. And that is going to be it for Vista View today, guys. Thank you for tuning in. If you don't watch me on Twitch, make sure you hit that Twitch button below. Subscribe to me on there, subscribe to me on Twitter so that you know all the updates and stuff on the channel and on the YouTube and Twitch channels, I guess I could say. I'm just rambling at this point. And that is going to be that for today. You guys have a great rest of the week. I will see you again later this week with another Dark Souls video. And then the weekend, some more Planet Coaster. Also, I just started a Patreon. I will put that link down below as well. If you guys want to support the channel, help me be able to afford more stuff in order to make quality videos and kind of upgrades and stuff like that to help the channel. I would very much appreciate it. That is it. Thanks for tuning in. Later.